Konnichiwa Bitches, zurück bei Let's Play The Stanley Parable in der zweiten Inkarnation, wenn ich es mal so nennen darf. Vielleicht Mutmaßung, keine Ahnung. Ja, wir sind wieder am Anfang.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Tja.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Ja, ja, das haben wir ja alles schon. Hier können wir ja noch nicht irgendwo anders hin. Ich glaube, jetzt muss ich mal ein paar...
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Ich glaube, ich mache das nochmal. Ich will nämlich wissen, was passiert, wenn man den Strom nicht ausstellt.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
Ja, ich weiß.
Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Ja, ja. Mhm. Ich mache das jetzt mal so schnell Durchlauf, ne?
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. What could it mean? Stanley was in such a rush to get through the story as quickly as possible, he didn't even have a single minute to just let the narrator talk. That kind of anxiety isn't healthy, so he relaxed for a few moments with some calming New Age music.
Das ist großartig.
Feeling soothed and rejuvenated, Stanley calmly walked forward into the opened passageway.
Ist das gut? Ist das gut? Okay. Und blub. Bäh, Gott. Ja, das dauert jetzt aber eng. Ich habe immer noch keine App oder irgendwas geholt, wo man irgendwelche dämlichen Sachen vorlesen kann. Das wäre eigentlich mal ganz gut. Ihr könnt mir eine empfehlen, wenn es so eine gibt. So eine, ja, nicht unbedingt Witze-App.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Das habe ich vor. Dup-di-dup-di-du.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens.
Ja, ich weiß.
What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
Tut mir leid, dass wir jetzt irgendwie alles nochmal sehen, aber ich glaube, das bleibt in dem Spiel nicht aus. So wie es aussieht.
Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen. And Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Ja, ich weiß. Elevator, please.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
So.
No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable. Wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
Wie wir einfach den ganzen letzten Part,
the heart of the operation, controls labeled with emotions,
jetzt in 4 Minuten gemacht haben.
Or sad, or content, walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Ja, ich mach mal an.
Oh, Stanley, you didn't just activate the controls, did you? After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted? Control? Oh, Stanley, I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go, turn the controls off, and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators are set to explode, eliminating the entire complex. How long until detonation then? Let's say, 2 minutes. Now this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley?
Total.
It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it.
Ich kann das doch bestimmt abstellen hier mit dem Ding.
But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going, what all this means. I barely know where to start. What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are? A moment of solace before you're obliterated. All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone. Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this, though. This version of events has been rather amusing.
Nine.
Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich. I almost hate to see it go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm enjoying this so much.
Nine.
You know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock, why not?
Ja, gut.
These are precious additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on trees. Oh dear me, what's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you. Running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room. These numbered buttons, no, these colored ones, or maybe this big red button, or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me. Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten? Won? Solved? Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is?
Stanley.
You're in for quite a disappointment. But here's a spoiler for you. That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along. It's just seconds ticking away to your death. You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless. To see you made humble. This is not a challenge. It's a tragedy. You wanted to control this world, that's fine. But I'm going to destroy it first, so you can't.
Take a look at the clock, Stanley.
That's 30 seconds you have left to struggle.
Ui, ui, ui.
30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing. No ending here, just you being blown to pieces. Will you cling desperately to your frail life, or will you let it go peacefully? Another choice? Make it count. Or don't. It's all the same to me. All a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life.
Oh my god,
the moment we fade in, until the moment I say happily ever up.
Whoopsie daisy. Ups. Okay, dann sind wir wieder am Anfang. Ich mach's jetzt mal anders, weil den Part jetzt zu beenden wäre ja scheiße. Bevor der jetzt anfängt zu quatschen. Ihr könnt ja mal sagen, was das mit den Zahlen auf sich hat. Ne? Vielleicht finde ich es auch noch selber raus. Aber wäre ganz
Stanley
cool, wenn das jemand weiß, dass
like
er mir das...
Hand. It was only a matter of time before he found the others, wherever they were. Just a matter of time.
Jetzt sagt er aber andere Sachen, ne? Das ist seltsam.
When When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Ich mache jetzt einfach mal was ganz anderes.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Ja, bestimmt. Stanley hat ja auch voll den Plan, so wie es aussieht. Der weiß ja Bescheid über alles.
Ah, yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room. Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
Okay.
Yes, really, really worth it being here in the room. A room so utterly captivating that even though all your co-workers have mysteriously vanished, here you sit looking at these chairs and some paintings. Really worth
Eigentlich
it.
Die Uhr. Ich will einen Drink.
At this point, Stanley's obsession with this room bordered on creepy and reflected poorly on his overall personality. It's possible that this is why everyone left.
Ich will eine Tasse hochnehmen. Jetzt kann ich keine Tassen mehr hochnehmen. Das finde ich doof.
Stanley sat around waiting for more dialogue. But when a long time had passed and there was no more, he decided that the game was trying to send him a message.
Ich habe das Gefühl, das passiert jetzt dann, oder? Ich will wissen, was auf dieser Tasse da steht. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. Machen wir ein bisschen Sport. Gut, ich glaube, wir sollen
But at
weiter.
Last, he'd had enough of the amazing room and took the first open door on his left to get back to business.
Nö. Aha.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Do not lie if you are lying right now. Stop. Na gut. Was ist das? Ein Kartenschlitz. Ich hab... Was? Ich hab kein gutes Gefühl.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her.
Her?
This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself. To put your work aside. To let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Ja, und wo? Bestimmt nicht hier. Nö. Sonst käme sie ja jetzt raus. Mhm. Ah.
That's her,
Telefon.
Stanley. You need to be the one to do this. To reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
Was ist, wenn ich das jetzt nicht mache? Ich mache das jetzt. Uah. What?
Oh, Stanley, is that you? Hold on, sweetie. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm just pulling the bread out of the oven. All right. Okay, there we go. All right, now, I want you to come in and tell me all about...
Your damn
Ah!
Gotcha! Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife who'd want to commit their life to you? I'm trying to make a point here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something. Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
Ich weiß gar nicht, ob ich das wissen will. Ich geh mal rein. Alter, hast du mich erschreckt?
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
Oh. Praise 8.
Stanley is quite a boring fellow. He has a job that demands nothing of him, and every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence. Look at him there, pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do. Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch. Now he's going home. Now he's coming back to work. One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life.
Ich drück jetzt O. Kann ich nicht.
But in his mind, in his mind he can go on fantastic adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown. Fantastic discoveries of new lands. It was wonderful. And each day that he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him.
Oh.
And so he began to fantasize about his own job. First, he imagined that one day while at work, he stepped up from his desk to realize that all of his co-workers, his boss, everyone in the building had suddenly vanished off the face of the earth. The thought excited him terribly.
Wo ist mein E hier?
So he went further. He imagined that he came to two open doors and that he could go through either. At last, choice. It barely even mattered what lay behind each door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold. As he wandered through this fantasy world, he began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations. Down one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls. And down another was a yellow line that weaved in many directions. And down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable.
Was?
It was such a wonderful fantasy. And so in his head, he relived it again. And then again. And again. Over and over. Wishing beyond hope that it would never end. That he might always feel this free. Surely there's an answer down some new path, mustn't there be? Perhaps if he played just one more time.
Aww.
But there is no answer. How could there possibly be? In reality, all he's doing is pushing the same buttons he always has. Nothing has changed. The longer he spends here, the more invested he gets, the more he forgets which life is the real one. And I'm trying to tell him this, that in this world he can never be anything but an observer, that as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop. Here, watch this. Stanley, the next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
Okay. Die Uhr tickt. Ja, was mache ich jetzt? Kann ich mittlerweile eine Zigarette drehen? Ich glaube, da passiert nichts mehr, oder? Das sieht nicht so aus. Ich mache das aber trotzdem nicht. Er hat gesagt, ich soll das nicht machen. Kann ich irgendwie noch laufen oder so? Nö, ich warte jetzt trotzdem. Also wenigstens so lange, bis ich mir die Kippe gedreht habe. Und dann, ja, wenn nichts passiert, dann muss ich den Knopf halt drücken. Kann ich denn jetzt zum Beispiel P drücken? Nö. Also ich kann es drücken, aber es passiert nichts. Tja. Das ist total spannend, ich weiß. Aber vielleicht passiert ja echt noch was, wenn man nur lang genug wartet. Aber scheinbar nicht. Weil ich drehe echt langsam und das... Ach, Mai, gut, dann drücke ich halt jetzt die 7.
You see?
Oh.
Can he just not hear me? How can I tell him in a way that he'll understand that every second he remains here, he's electing to kill himself? How can I get him to see what I see? How can I make him look at himself?
Spiegel? Ich mach hier mal den Cut rein. Wir machen dann nächstes Mal weiter. Ja, ich kann jetzt meine Zigarette rauchen. Das war toll. In aller Seelenruhe. Ich drück hier mal auf Escape, nicht, dass noch irgendwas passiert. Dann sehen wir uns beim nächsten Mal. Lasst mir ein bisschen Feedback da, wie ihr das Spiel findet. Das wird immer verwirrender. Ich find's total geil. Ich mach da jetzt auf jeden Fall noch ganz lange weiter. Grüne Daumen, Liebe für alle, die auch verwirrt sind. Und, ja, bis zum nächsten Mal. Wir singen.